Welcome to our 20th lecture. This lecture is based on frame leakage protection and percentage of unprotected winding against phase to earth fault. Generally, frame leakage protection is applied in the substation where all conductors are connected to a supporting structure which is called as fault bus, and that fault bus is grounded through the CT, and to that CT secondary we are connecting a relay. It is possible to design a station so that faults which developed are mostly earth fault by providing earth metal barrier surrounding each conductor in the bus structure. With this arrangement, every fault that might occur must involve a connection between conductor and earth metal part. Again, fault that occur will almost certainly be from a conductor to a supporting structure. That means that fault are almost all faults are earth fault that involves earth. In each of the preceding case, the metal supporting structure, also known as fault bus, is earth through a CT as shown in figure. A fault involving connection between a conductor and earth, that is supporting structure, will result in current flow through the CT and actuation of the relay connected to its secondary. Operation of this relay will result in tripping all the breakers connecting equipment to the bus. Sometimes we are adding impedance Z to limit the short circuit current during earth fault. Okay, you can see here, these are the conductors, these are insulators, and to this we are connecting a supporting bus. That bus is called as fault bus, and to this CT is connected. This is grounded, and to this in CT, it is grounded through CT. CT primary current is fault current. CT primary current, and that say in that CT secondary we are connecting a relay. The relay will trip according to the fault. This is about frame leakage protection. This is our last topic of protection. Okay. From next lecture we'll start switch gear. Okay. Now also one topic is remaining, that is percentage of unprotected winding against phase to earth fault in case of generator. The value of neutral earthing resistance and the amount of winding to be protected determines a relay fault setting. We are not protecting 100% part of this generator winding. We can protect only 80 to 85% of the winding, because there is spill current. Because of that spill current, we know due to CTC, due to that mismatch, we have spill current in the windings. Okay, so to avoid that, we are not protecting 100% part of generator winding. We are protecting 80 to 85% of alternator or transformer winding against earth fault. The remaining 15 to 20% from the neutral side is left unprotected. This is our three phase winding. Okay, in case of generator and transformer, from neutral 15 to 20% is left unprotected. It can be seen in figure. From phase to earth fault, that the setting required from the differential protection is determined by the value of neutral earthing resistor and also by amount of winding to be protected. Now look here, our fault current will flow. If there is earth fault, then that fault current will flow like this. It will go through the resistor. Okay, this neutral winding resistance can be calculated depending upon the value of fault current and this setting, and then the path will complete like this. Okay, this is our fault, and suppose fault is here, then fault current will complete its path through ground earth through this resistor, then like this it will complete its path. Now this x percentage of winding is protected, while 1 minus x is percentage of winding is unprotected. Percentage of winding, suppose this is our 100%, then x percent 80 to 85 we are protecting, while 1 minus x means 15 to 20% we are not protecting. Okay, so now we'll derive this equation. The earth fault current IF is given by this. IF is given by, here is our IF, fault current IF is given by 1 minus x V by R. 1 minus x, it will go like this. So it is 1 minus x, this voltage is V, this voltage is V, and this is resistance. So it is 1 minus, how much part, how the fault current is flowing through this part. So it is 1 minus x. IF is 1 minus x into V by R. This must be equal to the primary fault setting of the differential protection IS for minimum operating current. For minimum operating current, this IS, this IF must be equal to IS. Why? This fault current, if we are considering minimum, then this will be your minimum operating current in case of differential protection. So this IS is equal to IF. So IS is 1 minus x divided by VR, and now IR is, this IR is, it is V by R. This is, this voltage is V. So it is IR is V by R. So we can put this as, we can put this as IR. We can put this as IR. So now you will get x is 1 minus IS by IR. Now if you want to calculate value of x, it is x is 1 minus IS by IR. IS is primary fault setting current, IR is earthing resistance current setting, R is earthing resistance. Okay, so now percentage of winding unprotected, this x is percentage of winding protected, while 1 minus x is percentage of winding not protected or unprotected. X is percentage of winding to be protected or it is protected. So it is 1 minus x, definitely it is 1 minus x, IS by IR into 100. Now this IS by IR, IR is V by R. So IS into R divided by into 100. Okay. Now you have to solve this example. And write answer in chat box in our live lecture. Okay. Thank you.